Hello, High Levelers. Ray O'Daniel here. In this video, I want to really talk about why you would want to embed a Google Calendar on a high-level website. Some people might find that counterintuitive, like why would you do Google? Why not would you just use a calendar inside of high-level? So let's talk about that. Before we get started, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the subscribe button, hit that little bell so you get notified. I do appreciate your support. So, as a high-level user, one of the main things that I enjoy doing is attending the high-level events, the events that high-level puts on, and looking at their event calendar, which we're going to take a look at right here. Guess what? Look at what it is. It is a Google Calendar. So even high-level uses Google in their event calendar to keep all of their events nicely organized. So if you take a look at this page, I was looking at this one day and I'm like, why would I not want to show people how to do this feature inside of their own page? They might have an opportunity where, let's just say you wanted to create an events calendar for your company or for anybody, utilize Google and then post that on a particular page just so that it's visible to the website without having to go through and do it all inside of high level. People use Google Calendar. That's a sort of calendar that they collaborate with. So the team already has access to that. It's sort of an internal mechanism that people use to see when events are coming up. So why not just share that information? So I wanted to create a quick video to just show you how you would end up doing that. So before we get started, we do need to hop into our Google Calendar. I'm going to be using my personal calendar here. So I'm going to hop over here. Now, inside of your calendar, when you just go to calendar.google.com to access your calendar for that. Now, inside of Google, you can add multiple calendars to your account. You don't have to have just one. You can have multiple calendars all doing different things. And then, of course, you can overlay all of those appointments together on one calendar so you see them all. And then each calendar is color-coded and so forth. So all of that's done for you. But if you come over here and look, notice under the My Calendar areas, there's just my personal calendar, which I don't have selected right now, birthdays and tasks. This is pretty common. But one of the other things I want to show you here is some of the other calendars and the fact that you can click on this little plus button to add other calendars. So right now, what we're going to do is we're going to click on that other calendar and we're going to say create new calendar. I'm going to be a little bit vain and just say Ray O'Daniel events. I don't really hold events. I just want to look more important than I am. So if I could spell right here, so Ray O'Daniel events, just copy that description. I'll just put the same thing. Now it is important to sit back and make sure that you choose the right time zone. Okay. Because in order for Google to sort of figure out if you're saving appointments, you know, they need to know what appointment time the current originating calendar is in. So please make sure this is filled out correctly. And then it just has the owner. So I'm going to go ahead and just create the calendar. Now, this is just going to take just a minute for it to pop up. And when that does, we can simply come back over here to settings and notice that we have Ray O'Daniel events down here. Not only do we have Ray O'Daniel, but we have an events calendar now. Awesome. Okay. Well, this is the beginning of what we need to do to get it posted on the site. Now, you already may have a calendar like this, so you might not need to create a calendar. I get it. But if you don't have one, then you can at least create one. So right now, I'm going to start here. Let's just say the week of the 19th here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here. Let's just assume we're going to have a YouTube Live. We're going to go live every day at a certain time, and we want to make sure we put that on their events calendar. So I'm going to choose 2 p.m. Central. So I'm just going to double-click on that. And I'm just going to say, I'm going to create an event. And I'm just going to call it YouTube Live. So right now, this is going to be from 2 to 3 p.m. on this particular day. Now, it says does not repeat. This is where we want to change this. We want to click on this. And we want to say custom. And we can come in here and say Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So every day of the week except the weekends. So right now, if we take a look at it, it switches to weekly on weekdays. Perfect. Now, in here, if we wanted to, this is where you would need to populate all of the information with just the meeting information to make sure that people have it. So you might want to add, this is not going to be a Google Meet conference because we're going to be doing YouTube Lives. So you might want them to have a particular link for YouTube Live. So you can add that to the location here. You can set any other kind of meeting description notes that you want inside here. Again, I'm not going to do that here. I'm just trying to test a point for this one here, but we're going to simply click save. Now, notice that we've got YouTube Live across everything. And if we go to the next calendars for all the distant future, we see these events. Perfect. That's exactly what we wanted to. Now that we have this calendar, how do we put it inside of HighLevel? Okay, so before I kind of show you the calendar side, we need to make a position for it inside of a HighLevel website. So let's hop over and do that first. So over here in HighLevel, I just got a demo account. I'm gonna kind of come under sites and websites, and we just have a demo website. So I'm gonna open this up. And right now it doesn't really matter what page we do, but let's just say we take this about page. You know, we kind of want to keep the same color and same themes. So I'm going to click on this and I'm going to click clone because I want to make a copy of this page and then change it to add a calendar. So we're going to just choose a location. We're going to come down and choose our agency level, and we're going to just choose the website. We only have one, so there's only one to choose from. And we're going to say add selected page to site. When we do that, great. Here we go. We've got the settings. If we wanted to, we can change the name on this to events calendar. And if we wanted to, we could change the link to just say events, update the page. So now we have a nice events calendar. Now we can simply open up the page and start editing this. Not going to do a ton of edits on this one here. You kind of get the point. I'm just trying to show you the basic premise of how you would go set this up for yourself. So right now, we don't want any of this other stuff. So come over here and just delete these sections, delete the section, delete this section, and delete this big section. So I just really just chomped this page all the way up here. So what I want to do is come down here to this page, right about here, not here. Come on, sometimes it can be a little bit tricky. So here, I'm going to click on this. We want to do a full width section. We want to click on add row. It's just going to be a one column row. We just want a big column to add in our code. Now we're going to select add element, and we're not going to come down here and add a calendar. There is a calendar event here, but we don't want to do that. And why do we not want to do that? Because we're not adding a high level calendar. We're adding a Google calendar. So in order to do that, we have to use this custom JS HTML. So we're going to add that to the page. And what I want to do is stop right there. So I'm going to stop right here, pause, and go back over to the Google Calendar, because now we need to go get the embed code that we're going to put in that little code snippet from Google. And I'm going to show you how to do that. So here, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and click on settings. Over here, you see there's a whole bunch of settings, but if you click on down here, if we look at settings for my calendars, we see there's a Ray O'Daniel events calendar. So now this is selected here. Notice we have all of these different types of events down here. You could choose integrate calendar, or you can come over here. But one of the ways you can integrate this, you can have a link directly to it. We're not looking at that. We're looking at, here's the link. We're looking for the embed code. We're looking for this tech code. So if you click on it and you can, it highlights all of it. We're just gonna click copy. This is the code that we're looking for. And if you wanted to, I mean, we're not going to go ahead and customize it, but if you want to go through the customization, I'm just trying to show you the basics here of how you do this. You're going to come back into high level now. You're going to select on this code HTML JavaScript element, click open up code editor, and you're just simply going to paste that right in here and click yes, save. Now that you have that, unfortunately, with the custom HTML, the calendar does not render in design mode. So all we see here is the custom HTML. If you want to view it, you have to view it in a preview mode because the code has to execute in order for it to render on the page. So we're going to go ahead and click save. Not going to do anything to the SEO, and we're going to click preview. Now, when we do this, we see the header, and look at what we get. We get this nice little calendar that says Ray O'Daniel Events. We see all of our YouTube lives. And we can simply click on there. Notice we don't have any information because I was too lazy to fill all that stuff out. But if I'm really going to do this right, I'm going to sit back and fill out all the information that that goes along with this particular event. That way, when they click on this, they see where it is. They see the meeting link. They see all these other things regarding the event. Now, at this point, this is all it takes to simply put a Google Calendar on your page. Now, what about updates? What if I want to change something else here? So let's go ahead and take a look at this. If you update the Google Calendar, You'd never have to update this on the Go High Level website again. Okay. And again, this is, I'm showing you this on Go High Level, but you can literally put this, do this embed on any particular website as long as you use that HTML element that I showed you. But let's go ahead and just show you how updates work. So let's just say I come back here and I want to come back to this event. And now I want to do a 4 to 5 event, and I'm going to do tech office hours. Okay, so I'm gonna have some office hours, and I want that to repeat, and I'm gonna choose custom, and I'm gonna say I'm gonna make that available Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So these are the days I want it available, and I'm gonna click save. I'm not gonna fill anything out because I'm kind of lazy right now, but you see now I've went in behind the scenes and changed and added some additional events to this calendar. Well, what happened on the Google Embed calendar that we already put on the website? Let's hop back over here and take a look. All we have to do is just simply click refresh and then look at what happens. All of the nice tech office hours just automatically show up. So again, just wanted to show you, this is a one-time setup. You do this, you get it set up, and then you never have to touch it again. And then you have this nice, cool-looking calendar, how HighLevel has all this information in here. You get this type of look and feel on your own page using a Google Calendar that's free, or if you're paying for it, then you get the point, but you can create whatever calendar you want, however number of calendars, but that's how you do it, people. It's literally that easy. I hope you found the video useful. If you do, please click on the comment button, leave me a comment. I always appreciate that. If there's any questions I didn't answer, please leave a comment, ask, because if you're asking the question, most likely somebody else is too. Again, if you have not subscribed, click on the subscribe button on my channel. I appreciate you so much, and you guys have a great day. Hey, if you're interested in learning more about HighLevel, click on the link below regarding my free HighLevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with HighLevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.